Good morning to everyone. My name is Madhupriya, studying in 10th standard. Today I am going to tell about trigonometry, one of the toughest chapters in the maths. So let's see it. Our 10th class exams are starting from June 8th. So please see this video and learn more maths. Let's divide this meaning of trigonometry and learn about it. The word tri means 3. Gono means angles. Metri means measurement. Three angle measurement. The whole trigonometry chapter will based upon the right angle triangle. Let's draw a right angle triangle and name these points as A, B and C. The B is 90 degrees angle. Let's assume that this angle C is theta. Now, as AC is the longest side, we name it as hypotenuse. And side AB is exactly opposite to angle C, we name it as opposite. And the other side BC, we name it as adjacent. Based on these sides, we learn about trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric ratios are of 6 types. First one is sin theta. Second one is cos theta. And the third one, tan theta. Fourth one, cosecant theta. Fifth one, secant theta. Sixth one is the last one, it is cot theta. Now, sin theta means, coming to a right angle triangle, sin theta means opposite by hypotenuse. Let's write AB by AC. Cos theta means adjacent by hypotenuse.
Tan theta, opposite by adjacent. It is AB by BC. Cosecant theta, it is reciprocal of sin theta. So, sin theta value is opposite by hypotenuse. Then, cosecant theta value will be hypotenuse by opposite, AC by AB, exactly reciprocal of sin theta. Now, cos theta is the reciprocal of secant theta. Then the value of secant theta will be hypotenuse by adjacent. It is AC by BC. Tan theta is reciprocal of cot theta. So, the value of cot theta will be adjacent by opposite. It is BC by AB. As sin theta is reciprocal of cosecant theta, we write it as sin theta into cosecant theta is equal to 1. Then the value of sin theta will be equal to sin theta is equal to 1 by cosecant theta. Then the value of cosecant theta becomes 1 by sin theta. As tan theta is reciprocal of cot theta, we write it as tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. Tan theta is equal to 1 by cot theta. Then the value of cot theta will be 1 by tan theta. Now, the third one. As secant theta is reciprocal of cos theta, we write it as secant theta into cos theta is equal to 1. Secant theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. And cos theta is equal to 1 by secant theta. Based on this multiplicative inverse of trigonometric ratios, we learn about one problem.
Tan theta is equal to 4, then we have to find sin theta and cos theta. Now, let's draw a right angle triangle. Name these points as A, B and C. B is 90 degrees and C is theta. Now, tan theta, we can write this 3 tan theta is equal to 4 as tan theta is equal to 4 by 3. Tan theta is opposite by adjacent. 4 is opposite. Adjacent is 3. Now, tan theta is equal to 4 by 3. According to Pythagoras theorem, AC whole square is equal to AB whole square plus BC whole square. AC whole square. We don't know the value of AC, then leave it as AC. Then AB. The value of AB is 4. 4 whole square plus BC is 3. 3 whole square. 4 square is 60. 3 square 9. 6 plus 9 is 25. 16 plus 9 is 25. AC whole square is equal to 25. AC is equal to square root of 25. Then the value of AC becomes 5. So now we know about the value of AC. It's 5. Now we have to find sin theta and cos theta. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite means AB by AC. It's 4 by 5 is sin theta. Then we have to find cos theta. Cos theta is adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent is BC by AC. The value of BC is 3 and AC is 5. So we write it as 3 by 5. So they give tan theta value. So like this, we have to find the sin theta and cos theta values based on this multiplicative inverse of trigonometric ratios. Up to now, we have learned about trigonometric ratios and multiplicative inverse of the trigonometric ratios. Now see, we will see about sin theta, cos theta, these trigonometric ratios in degrees values 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degrees. For that, I will tell you a trick to find the value of sin theta in degrees. Now, to find the sin theta values, so let's write 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, divide each of the following with 4. And add a square root to each of the following. Now, if we solve this, we get this value as 0 and we get this value as 1 by 2 and we get this value as root 2 by 2 and we write it as root 2 by 2 as 1 by root 2. We will write this root 3 by 4 as root 3 by 2. This as 1. Now we write these values in this box. 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1. As coming to this box, sin theta becomes reciprocal of cos theta. So the value of 90 degrees of sin theta becomes equal to cos theta 0 degrees. So 1, cos theta 0 degrees is 1. Cos theta 30 degrees is root 3 by 2, cos theta 45 is root 2, cos 60 degrees is 1 by 2 and cos 90 degrees is 0. Now tan theta, we write tan theta as sin theta by cos theta. So sin theta by cos theta, 0 by 1, it's 0. 1 by 2 by root 3 by 2, it's 1 by root 3. 1 by 2 by 1 by root 2, it's 1. Root 3 by 2 by 1 by 2 is root 3. 1 by 0, any number which we divide by 0, it's not defined. So the value is not defined. know. Tan theta is reciprocal of cot theta, so the value of cot 0 degrees is not defined. And cos 30 is root 3, cos 45 is 1, cos 60 is 1 by root 3, and cos 90 is 0. Exactly reciprocal of tan theta. Now, the value of secant 0 is 1, and the value of secant 30 is 2 by root 3, and secant 45 is root 2, and secant 60 is 2, and secant 90 is not defined. Secant is reciprocal of cos theta, so we write these values as exactly inverse of cosecant theta. Cosecant theta 0 is not defined, and cosecant 30 degrees is 2, cosecant 45 is root 2, cosecant 60 is 2 by root 3, and cosecant 90 is 1. Based on this table, let's see a problem. 2 tan square 45 degrees plus cos square 30 degrees minus sin square 60 degrees. So, we have to solve this problem. 2 tan square 45 is 1 cos square plus cos square 30 is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 whole square minus sin square 60 is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 whole square. 1 square is 1. 2 into 1 is 2 plus root 3 whole square by 2 square minus root 3 whole square by 2 whole square. 2 plus root and this square gets cancelled. 3 by 2 whole square is 4 minus this root and square get cancelled, and we write it as 3 by 4. Now the LCM is 4. Here we get 8 plus 3 minus 3. It is 8 by 4. So the value is 2. Now we add AC to each of the following. AC by AC whole square is equal to AB by AC whole square plus BC by AC whole square. If we cancel this, we get 1. AB by AC is sine square theta. BC by AC is cos square theta. It's an identity, first identity. Now, sin square theta plus cos square theta. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now, the value of sin square theta becomes 1 minus cos square theta. Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Then the second identity is secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and tan square theta is equal to secant square theta minus 1. And the last identity is cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1, and cosecant square theta becomes 1 plus cot theta, and cot theta is equal to cosecant square theta minus 1. Now, based on that, we'll do a problem. If secant theta plus tan theta is equal to P, then prove that sin theta is equal to P square plus minus 1 by P square plus 1. Now, coming to identities, secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Given secant theta plus tan theta is equal to P. Now, A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. So, it is in the form of A square minus B square. So, we write it as secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1. Now, secant theta plus tan theta is equal to P. It's given. So, let's write it as P. P into secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1. Then the value of secant theta minus tan theta becomes 1 by P. So, let's name this equation as 1 and name this equation as 2. From 1 and 2, now we will add 1 plus 2. That is, secant theta plus tan theta is equal to P, its first equation, and secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by P, its second equation. Now, we are adding this equation, so these values will cancel. 2 secant theta is equal to P plus 1 by P. It's become secant theta is equal to P plus. Now LCM becomes P. P square plus 1. Now this secant theta becomes P square plus 1 by 2P. Now we know the value. If we add 1 plus 2, we get secant theta is equal to P square plus 1 by 2P. Now, we will subtract 1 minus 2. We get secant theta plus tan theta is equal to P and secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1 by P. Now, as we subtract, we change these symbols. Secant theta gets cancelled. This 2 tan theta is equal to P minus 1 by P. Now 2 tan theta is equal to P minus 1 by P. Now we write it as 2 tan theta is equal to P minus 1 by P. The LCM becomes P square minus 1 by P. Now tan theta is equal to P square minus 1 by 2P. We name this equation as 4. From 3 and 4 we write it as. Now we divide 4 by 3. It's the equation 4 is tan theta is equal to P square minus 1 by 2P and secant theta is equal to P square plus 1 by 2P. Now we cancel this 2P and 2P. We write it as tan theta is sin theta by cos theta and the secant theta is 1 by cos theta and we get it as P square minus 1 by P square plus 1. Cos theta gets cancelled. Now we get as sin theta is equal to P square minus 1 by P square plus 1. Hence, proved. This is the 4 marks problem which is very helpful for exams. So, please, this is about trigonometry. Hope you understand better. Thank you. Now, please share this video to all the 10th class students. Now, my friend Bhavani will tell you about progressions in the next video. Thank you.